Everybody, what is going on? It is Dunbar Snackbar. It's time for another episode of Give Her a Go. In this series, I end up playing a random mission out of the ARMA 3 Steam Workshop, and I rate it for you guys. That way you can determine whether or not this is a game that you would want to play with yourself or with friends, whatever you want. But this mission is called Disarmament, created by Reaper, as you can see right here, and already I am liking what I see from this mission. The first couple episodes of Give Her a Go, I felt, weren't that great. I'm just going to go out there and say it. The reason why is while I did play what are among the top rated missions of all time with ARMA 3, I already feel like that this game has more attention that has been like put into it and far more detail than those missions did. So this gives me hope. I love this introduction to it. Now, of course, I changed the music like I always do, but still, this is pretty cool. I will give you guys a heads up, too, that I did end up cutting this into a number of episodes. I think it's either two or three, because this mission ended up being 3.5 hours long. Now, that's another thing that really gets me excited, too, about this. I did spend the first half hour just changing the loadout of me and my team. You can see there's a total of 6 people. I'm, of course, one of them. This also is a mission you can play with 5 other friends too, so for a total of 6. So I felt like if users come in and they can change their loadouts, I should also change the loadouts of my team members. I feel like if I was in charge of this too, I would be kind of saying, hey, you equip yourself with this, I don't care what, just you're that, you're, and then another person fills another role and so on and so forth. So I'm okay with the fact that I changed the loadouts. I didn't change it too much because I did kind of want to keep to what this mission was all about, what the creator originally intended for it. So the same roles are there, I just changed the weapons to their black versions, and I gave everybody a ton, and I mean a ton of med packs, a ton of ammunition, and yeah, so we're carrying a lot of stuff. But that's also because I don't know what to expect. The only information that I have regarding what this mission entails is that we're on Altus, and there's a group who wants to engage in a military coup. And so our job is to find the leader of that and to take him out. But not only does he have some men with him, but he also has a couple tanks and he has some fast movers as well. So this mission encompasses a lot of different things, I think. I haven't seen anything quite yet. Now that we've been dropped off here in what appears to be our base, what we have to do is meet with our informant, who I'm guessing is going to inform us on what exactly to expect. I'm armed with an M14 this time. I haven't actually used the M14 in this game yet, so I thought this would be a good opportunity. Fill the marksman role a little bit too. I do have a sniper, but this way we can kind of like team up and engage enemies from long range. It's pretty cool what Reaper has done right here too with the scripting. I mean, this base looks like it's pretty well defended, and I don't think we're going to be spending too much time here either. So again, a lot of attention to detail, even in times that might not necessarily be that important. So up ahead, we have an off-road vehicle. You can see that pickup. We're going to end up going into this pickup, and we're going to go near the location of the informant. We don't want to go exactly to his location because a lot of things could be happening that might make it so we don't want to end up driving right up there. Could be an ambush set up for us. He could already be under fire by the enemy. And if we end up getting hit inside this truck, our whole team is wiped out. It's not good. I've split up the team into 2 different groups. Team Red just consists of our medic. I'm keeping him in the pickup truck just in case things do get pretty crazy. He can come pick us up. And then everybody else is in Team Green. I've got an explosive specialist, as I mentioned, the sniper. I have an AR, and I also have somebody with AT weaponry, just in case we come up against any vehicles. Being very cautious here as we move up towards this hill, I'm looking in a number of directions, just making sure there is no enemy waiting to surprise us. This is probably not the best approach to take towards this hill, but I did want to make sure I got into cover as quickly as possible and also got to the location that we needed to be as quickly as possible. So kind of pick up the pace, I stop, and again I'm looking around just seeing if there's any enemy on the other hill, and I'm not seeing anybody either, so I turn my attention towards the informant, and definitely looks like a civilian, blue shirt, blue pickup. Well, things look all right, so I'm going to end up moving in towards him. We'll see exactly what information that he can give me, because as I looked at the map on the way over, there was literally nothing in there that could provide me any information about where this guy is or where any of his military assets are that could pose a threat to Altus. So we come around, make sure he knows we're here, because he didn't see us come up on him. And nothing? Nothing from him at all?
Okay, we have the info. Your message updated.
Take cover. Oh, okay. Solid copy. Covering fire. So telling my guys to kind of take cover here. If we're going to be ambushed, now would be the time as he's kind of heading out. But I don't think we will. I'm going to end up moving close to him and just see what happens as he goes off. But I don't know. I think we're all right. So I'm going to get my medic to come over to this intersection and to come pick us up. Now we do have some information on our map. The first objective, as you saw, was to take out the guy who's in charge of the coup. So I end up moving towards the location. You can see a couple red spots where there is enemy. So I wanted to make sure I came in from the west. But I don't get as far as I would like, because up ahead I see what looked like a checkpoint. I tell my team to stop. We're going to go with a hard dismount here. I don't want anybody to still be in this truck just in case things do get pretty crazy. I want to have everybody engaging the enemy as necessary. Move up just a little bit, but I'm going to go prone in just a moment. And I'm going to take a look down my sights and see what I can find up at that checkpoint. Now, I do know for sure now that there is an enemy rifleman up there. But I don't know how well defended that this checkpoint is. Looks like there's two infantry, AT on the left, and we've got a rifleman on the right. Get out. So we'll get everybody laying down in a firing line. The reason why I'm having them lay down is just for increased accuracy. When we do open fire, we're going to surprise them all at once. I am debating, too, whether or not I should have my sniper open fire with me at the exact same time so we can take them out pretty quick. I think they said about 600 meters out, but I'm going to go and get this to...
Eyes on target.
Yep. Okay, so my rangefinder tells me it is 600 meters. Go back to the rifle. Get the bipod out, just for stability.
We've got an enemy. Man.
We're going to open fire here just pretty soon.
AT soldier, 600 meters northwest.
Four, target that soldier, northwest.
All right, I've got the sniper engaging the other ready soldier once I give the order to fire.
Four, fire at will.
Oh, I got mine, but it looks like my sniper didn't. Just short. There we go. Okay, so we've taken them both down. So we should be able to advance quite a ways before the enemy starts to see us. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move up to that hill right in front of us. That should give us a good elevated position over where the enemy is. We might be able to engage them from that elevated position and catch more of them by surprise. Since we've only fired a few shots, I don't think the main enemy force knows that we're here. Though I don't want to take that risk, so I'm not going to be storming in to this compound here. Got the rest of the team with me. We make it up this hill for a little bit of a ways. What I'm going to do is turn over to the east a little bit. Remember, there was a couple dots where there was actually enemy, and I want to look in that direction. And I think I'm starting to see them in the top third of the screen along that road. So I'm going to move into a firing position over here. And again, we're going to form a line too and just kind of go with this same type of strategy that we used before. And this is one that I use quite a bit as well, where we just go prone and all open fire at once and take down as many as we can, as quickly as we can, with the element of surprise. Obviously, while the enemy is standing up, makes it a lot easier for us to hit them. And as soon as we open fire, they usually hit the dirt. So this is the best time to hit them. My guys are calling out APCs too, which is worrying. because they can obviously hit me at a longer range. We're still looking at about 600 yards, so I won't have to adjust my sights at all to accommodate for it. Oh. Open fire, man. Oh, wait, that's a helicopter up there. All right, two of them missed. Man, he's just expended all of his ammunition, too. So forget that. I don't have an AT anymore. I have just a rifleman. Great. So if we come in contact with any type of armor, remember there was that APC earlier, we're in trouble. And now that's alerted them, too. So that was honestly a terrible decision. We're going to open fire, though. Try and take out the enemy. And that guy's laying down. Alright, nothing. Gosh, I am not doing too hot right now. Now, I like, too, that with this weapon, it doesn't go exactly in the same spot every single time. Whether that's wind, whether that's just the rifle that I'm using or what. Oh, I got a hit. It is somewhat frustrating that it's never in the same location. Oh, there's two hits. Why hasn't he died yet?
Target neutralized.
That was three. I've just gone through a mag. Maybe he's dead already? I mean, he hasn't moved. Let me just try and readjust here. Again, still hasn't moved. Those posts are in the way, so it's hard for me to see exactly what's going on, what status he is. But I can't zoom in anymore with this scope. I didn't want to go with the super heavy one for intense zooming in, just because I didn't feel like that would be appropriate on an M14. Yeah, this guy's got to be dead. That's two straight hits now. Whoops, I just went through a lot of ammunition shooting a dead guy. Great. Alright, there is his position, and you saw that there were some potential escape points too. Stop. Oh my gosh. This was actually kind of embarrassing. Me shooting a dead guy, my guy's on the right, because my sniper keeps shooting at something, and my AT rifleman has gone through all of his ammunition. So not a good start to this mission. What we're going to be doing now is we're going to keep going along this hill. The ultimate goal that we have is, and I'll show it to you here in a little bit, is to keep moving towards the north and try to see if we can keep engaging enemy along the way. Periodically, though, we're seeing there are enemy. This guy's about a click out.
One click north. Soldier,
so I'm adjusting. I'm now at one click. Oh, but that was way high and to the left. So forget him right now. These guys are a lot closer and are more of a threat. They also don't know we're here. So we're opening fire on them. Looks like there's three. Aim that a little lower. No, we'll go up. Can I hit the guy behind him instead? Well, there's one hit on him.
Medic, 700 meters north.
Dang it. I keep trying to adjust for the wind, and it doesn't do anything either. So I'm just going to center it on him and just keep trying to hit him. Oh my gosh, this is annoying. If the rest of it is like this too, I'm going to be livid. All right. There we go. Got him.
APC, 1.5 clicks, northeast.
And got that guy too. All right, made up for it. Two shots, two kills. Though we'll ignore the fact that it took about 12 earlier to kill that guy. All right, remember, this guy's one click out, readjusted. Gosh, that is way too high for one click. So I'm going to readjust for 900. That was too low. Move up a little bit. Try again. Oh, down a little bit. Oh, got him from a click out. That's not bad. Okay. I'm not seeing anybody now. What is my sniper shooting at?
Four.
Oh, if it's those same guys over in the base, I'm just, telling him to hold fire right now. I am sick of that. Okay, 500 meters.
One click east.
At bearing 30. Trying to look in that direction, but I'm not seeing anything. There's a lot more guys, it looks like, that are showing up, but that has to be those guys in the base. Oh, there he is. Okay. What was it? 500 meters? All right, readjusted.
Target's down. Dang it.
Well, I don't have to worry about that guy. My guys already took him down. Just to confirm it, yeah, he's dead. All right, we're back on the move. There's those trees that are right over to the left now. We're going to try and head to those. And that's going to be the position which we'll start our attack from. So you can see now, this is the maneuver that I'm going to try and complete. And kind of move in towards where the enemy is. So I'm kind of starting on that route. We're seeing some more guys over to our left. I'm completely ignoring the guys to our right. But my team isn't. I see this MRAP here. And I think that's somebody laying on the road. So I'm trying to get into a position where I can lay down and also where I'll be able to trample some of these bushes in front of us too, because it's so tough to be able to see
over them. Target acquired.
All right, 500 yards again. Set up for it. I'm not telling my team to open fire. I've got this. You see, they're still focused on the right.
Enemy spotted. Soldier, half a click, northeast.
All right. I'm trying to tell them what target to get, but I'm not going to worry about it. Let's get the rangefinder out and make sure this is the 500-meter one that we saw. Yeah.
Eyes on target.
Just a little bit under. I don't have anything to hit that with right now, so the only hope that I have of making sure that this vehicle isn't a threat is by
target
killing
acquired.
Those who might man the vehicle. So there's that one guy down there. There's got to be more than one, though, because there has to be a gunner.
Weapons free.
All right.
Target down.
Oh, man. Two got him. There more? Oh, if that sniper shooting again.
There's an enemy. Sniper. Spec op. One and a half clicks.
Jeez.
I've got a visual. Rifleman. One click east.
Scratch oh, there is
one.
Somebody else along the road. You gotta be careful. Alright, we're just gonna keep moving. Seems like there is somebody else on the road
four,
right by that MRAP.
Fire.
Stop! Oh
four,
my gosh.
Hold fire.
There's somebody else by that MRAP. So we're going to try and continue to move on that route I showed you earlier and see if we can get a better eye on what might be down there. Just taking a look at some of these buildings, too. We know that the head guy of this coup is here. And so he'd likely be around some of these buildings in these houses or whatnot. So we might have to clear the buildings as well. Oh, there's somebody else.
Soldier, half a click, bearing 030.
I wonder if that's the other guy that we saw on the map. I'm going to move back to a position where these bushes are trampled. Make it easier to see. Gosh, my guys are good. I want to do some research on this because I don't know how much of a role the optics, the scopes, whatever you put on a weapon, how much that affects AI accuracy. Because originally in this mission, the AI is equipped to just use iron sights, but I went ahead and gave them some optics that have two mounts to them. I mean, I don't know if the computer switches back and forth. There's somebody else.
Fire!
Target in sight.
All right. I think by now my sniper's not really
two,
engaging
three,
them.
Five, six. Hold
like those
fire.
Guys that are over to the right in that military structure. I'm going to try and bypass that altogether. Move back and
we
see
got an
if I can get a
medic,
better view.
Us.
Oh, 75 fire. Meters right there. All right, switching to that site. Got him. Okay. Oh, man. He was right behind the tree. Of course I couldn't have seen him. Now me and the two other guys are down, and this is one of the things that kind of sets this particular scenario apart from some other ones that you play. Looks like Reaper has created his own framework, and things are a lot different as far as healing. So, calling a medic, nobody's nearby. Sounds like they're still engaging the guy who was back there. So I'm like, okay, let's try this out a little bit. Seems like whenever you click this arrow, you can kind of change camera angles, stuff like that. So things are a little quiet. 7 meters away. Come on. I don't want to bleed out, man. Come on. Medic. Where is the medic? Two, Team Red, where are you? It feels like one of the things that they do to compensate for the fact that there are these revives is damage is increased. As I mentioned earlier, the M14 isn't something that I've used before. But from what I can see from the damage that some of my other teammates are dishing out towards the enemy right now, it seems like damage may be increased. And a lot of times, one shot like that wouldn't have killed me unless it was right in the head.
Ready.
This seems to be a good spot, though. We're engaging the enemy. Seems like to be no shortage right now. All right, we've got some more. My sniper's firing, which I'm hoping our guy's down here. It looks like I've missed actually quite a bit. There was the one guy that I took down at short range. The enemy came up with another guy that we took down.
Hostile
down. Now I've got guys in a 360 security here, just making sure this location's okay. While the sniper's looking down at the enemy. So we're going to end up pushing towards these buildings. I've just completed that maneuver. Wasn't quite pretty at the end. As we push up, there's another enemy that's moving behind those trees. Now he's behind that bush, so I can't see him at all. And now he's shooting at me, so I just take a quick shot. And I'm going to hide behind this tree so he can't hit me. Except for the fact that he can hit me through a tree, mind you. So once again, I'm going to have to wait. A lot of the guys are just pretty far behind me, too. It's one of the things that just happens in a lot of missions whenever you're going with AI. And that is, you know, you'll move up, but they won't follow you nearly as quick because they'll do a tactical movement where one person will be prone, another person will be running past, another person will be covering, and then you just alternate between spots, basically. And that's all fine and dandy when you're like playing with players and stuff like that, but just in situations like this where it's like you're behind a hill, it's okay for you guys to come up. So now it's just me and the sniper.
Return to formation.
Seems like he's engaging somebody over to our left. Just want to make sure the guy in front of me is dead, because he's able to shoot me through trees, so I gotta watch out. Oh, who got hit? Oh, sniper got hit. Alright, it might be my turn here to try and heal him. There's somebody
at
that road.
Alright,
I'm gonna get my guys to lay down some covering fire, start engaging them. Oh, somebody's already coming up to heal him.
Standing by.
Oh, that's cool that it happens automatically. Oh, come on. Dang it. Alright, heal myself. I didn't have to go and pass out or be heavily wounded before I can heal myself, which is good.
Ready.
Alright, so everybody is in front of us. This is the third person now that we've seen at close range. As we keep moving up closer, we're coming up against heavier fire. So it looks like we're going in the right direction. I'm not afraid to have my guys go on a push. Remember, I'm a marksman, so I'm not that well equipped to be among the guys that are going in first. And besides, the AI is a lot better at spotting people than I am. But this would be cool with the
northwest.
All right, you guys, 300.
200 meters.
Got him.
At ease.
Dang it.
200 meters. Front.
Man, I am having terrible luck.
Another timer.
I just hope the rest of it isn't like this. Because this is a lot of times I've had to be revived. Well, luckily, Jackson's there to heal me up pretty quick. And I'm really glad I made sure everybody had a lot of first aid kits. Though I've been dropped far more than anybody else has. I'm still good, man. I'm still good. Okay. There's a chopper right in front of us. I think that was one of the ways he could escape. If you remember, on the map, when it showed his position, there was also a few places that mark positions of possible escape. There's got to be someone in it. Otherwise, my grenadier, which is my medic, by the way, wouldn't be launching all of these 40mm rounds at it. Oh, jeez, what? I'm just getting down behind this rock. I should have stayed back. That probably would have been the best thing to do. Slowing down cover. Oh, the pilot got out. Oh, sniper got him. All right, we're going to move up. Remember how I said he could be at some of these buildings? Maybe he's over here, and that's why the defense was tough. Okay, I'm not moving in by myself. Making sure these guys get on me. And then we'll move in together. Alright. Nothing over here. Guys are going to be close proximity. Potentially. Nope. Looks like we're good. Oh, there's some... Oh! I think those were his bodyguards. That's him. Got him.
Two at ease.
All right, so what we're going to be doing now is we're going to destroy the tanks, but with as much time as this has taken for me to go through and finish the first part of the mission, I think we'll just end it here, and then I'll show you more in the next video. I can't go in this chopper. This would be so nice to use, be able to move around. No, I don't need any parachutes. There's nothing in there I can really use. So, as I mentioned, there's more of this to come. I think there'll be two or three parts. It depends how much longer we've got. It's like 2 hours of content is what's left. So the plan for the mission, for the next part for sure, and what we're... heading out on foot to get to now is an ammo depot that's pretty close. With Stuart, my AT guy, having used up all his ammunition, we're going to try and push to the ammo depot and then finally up to those hidden tanks. That's where we're going to be going to. I doubt it's going to be an easy walk if I follow the path that has kind of been set. I do want to stick to the high ground to give as much warning to us as possible of enemy. Got to be careful, though, that I don't silhouette myself on top of the hill and end up being spotted by the enemy in return. So this is going to be a delicate movement, and we'll probably come under some fire along the way. So you'll definitely have to check out the next video, too, to see what happens, because I'm not going to lie, it's exciting. So thanks for watching, you guys. I sure do appreciate it. More of this mission to come later on, so I'm not going to rate it quite yet. Feel free to subscribe if you haven't already. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, all that great jazz. But you guys are phenomenal people. You really are. Thank you again for watching, you guys. As always, I hope you have a good one.